Hey, what's up, everyone, and welcome back to the Snakemake series. I'm your host, Marcus Morgan, and in this video, I will show you how to integrate Snakemake with Docker, these two excellent tools to make your pipeline reproducible and well-documented. The way I like to integrate Docker is to use one image per rule. Sounds interesting, right? Let's get started. Assuming you already have Docker installed, the first thing we are going to do is pull two Docker images from the web. We are going to use the command docker pull to download these images. First, we are going to download the Docker diverse image made by Docker, which we can search for within Docker Hub. It will take a couple of minutes to finish, and once that's done, we'll download the minimap2 image from this other repository. Now let's implement the first step of the pipeline, which is to create a rule that takes the file sample underscore txt as input and give it to rule run docker. This rule will produce the file copy underscore txt by invoking the minimap2 image that we just pulled from Docker Hub. This is probably the most important line of code that I want to share with you today, and is this docker run minus v pwd, pwd, and minus w, pwd. We are going to run this command and create the run docker rule with sample txt as input and copy underscore txt as output. We are going to pass the docker run and the mini image as parameters. Then we are going to write a simple shell command where we invoke the docker part of the script, and then we invoke the minimap part of the script. And the first thing that we're going to do is just use the cp function within this image to copy the input into the output. So when we run the pipeline, we can see that the copy underscore txt is generated. We see that it's a copy of sample txt and that they are the same as expected. Let's make sure that we are actually running a command within the image. We are going to create a log file here to show this. If you are not sure about what log files are, I recommend you check out our previous videos on debugging Snakemake. So we are going to use the minimap function within the image, and we will give it what is the input so that it pretends to run something. It will not do much, but it will not break at least. And we will put whatever is going into the console to this log file. Now let's relaunch the pipeline. We can see that it runs without any problem, and we can see that we generate the log and the output files. The log file contains all the input to the console that is specific to minimap, so we know that minimap has been run and the file copy underscore a doesn't have anything because there's nothing for the function to do there, so it's an empty file, but that's fine. But now what happens if we remove these minus v and minus w stub? So when we launch the pipeline, it starts to run, but it invokes an error to check what's the problem. We need to look at our log file, and it says failed to open file, not such a file of directory. That's because there's no directory in the image to look with the files because we haven't mounted the volume. So we're going to add two new rules now to our pipeline. The first one is run rocker rule, which takes copy underscore a and generates a file underscore txt. We'll then define rule all that receives this final a file as input. If you are not sure what rule all does, make sure to check out our previous videos in this series. We're explaining in detail. For the run docker rule, we are going to use a different image this time, the rocker image. It might take a little longer to explain, but don't worry, I will not worry you with all the details. First, we'll define the rule all for the final file, and then define the run rocker rule that takes the input copy underscore txt and generates the output file underscore txt. We'll also generate a log file to track any error message for these rules. Once again, we'll pass the docker and the image parameters. We'll need to update the mini image to the rocker image eventually, but we'll go today and later. We'll then run an R markdown script, but if you're not unsure how to run R markdown, in your Snakemake image pipeline, we got another video for that that I highly recommend you to check. Their markdown file we'll be using is script.rmd, which we'll pass the input and output files to. This function will copy whatever is in the copy underscore file and write it into the final underscore file. Now let's start the pipeline and see it in action. First, we'll run the broker part, which should complete without any issues. And then we launch the R markdown part. And just like that, it's done. Let me just quickly check the final underscore A file. And yes, the first line is blank. And then we have the directory that we use as expected, showing that there is a good mounting of the model. Now you might be wondering what the line minus D, DWD, PWD, minus W, DWD is all about. Well, let's have a representation of the directory structure in the image and the computer. In the computer, we can have a complex directory structure with multiple directories. So to mount the directory that we want it to the image, we use the B flag, and we start from volume, and PWD is actually a variable where we encode the current working directory. That's the one that we want to mount. However, we need to be careful when we do this because we can only work on the directories that are downstream this mounting directory. And also we need to make sure that we start working from that working directory, and that's where the W variable comes. Well, I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more data science tips and tricks. And don't forget to check our other videos in this series to become a pipeline pro. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.